Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, no time to look back. But the same day Lot went out of Sodom, it rained fire and brimstone from heaven and destroyed them all. Even thus shall it be in the day when the Son of Man is revealed. In that day, he which shall be upon the housetop and his stuff in the house, let him not come down to take it away. And he that is in the field, let him likewise not return back. Remember Lot's wife? Whosoever shall seek to save his life shall lose it, and whosoever shall lose his life shall preserve it. Luke 17:29-33. Today there are too many people living on the edge, living too close to deception, too close to just jumping right back in the past and with all of its failures. Ask yourself about how bad it was and how bad you had it before God dragged you out of the pit. Ask yourself, how bad would I be if I turned back and took up the more spirits even worse than the ones that I had? Ask yourself, how did it affect my family, friends, and all those around me? In Matthew 12:44, it tells us that the spirit that left the man said, I will return from whence I came. So when the spirit returns to the man's heart and find it empty, then that demon finds several other spirits worse than himself and then lives in that man again. And the last state of that man is worse than the first. We find ourselves living on the edge because life is not as we want it. We are not seeing the results of our faithfulness to God bringing rewards we expect to receive. In other words, people turn back from God because God doesn't produce for us fast enough. We grow discouraged and the enemy sees an opening to come back and then brings more misery than we ever know before. And not only us, but our families and friends will suffer for our sin. I've seen this so many times, even before I got into ministry. I've seen people that seem to be on fire for God become nothing but just a puff of smoke. Child of God, to make it down the narrow road that leads to heaven, you have to walk in the middle of the road. People who walk on the edge eventually fall and they take everything and everyone that is beside them, meaning their family and friends and anything else that they can pull with them. How many people have tried to live both worlds, having one foot in the church and one foot in the world? We've seen so many people falling away from God, and we try to help, but then Satan is right there with his arms ready to receive them as they fall from the edge. There are some of you that are listening to me right now that are fighting to hang on. You know that if you let go of God, you're letting go of the only one who can truly save you. So you think to yourself, what if I fall? What about my family and friends, those who have testified to, those who have seen the change in my life? What will they think of me? Listen to the story. The one who was willing to pour it all out for Christ was saved, and the other who was willing to sell out was lost forever. We see in John 12 when Mary poured out the ointment of spikenard that was very costly to anoint Jesus. She was willing to give all she had, and eventually she obtained salvation. But Judas wanted to sell it, and he ended up losing his soul in the process. The story tells us the real heart of Judas who betrayed Christ. He was self-motivated, not led of the Lord like the others. Judas had influence on many people. Remember, he was among those that Christ sent out to preach the gospel, to cast devils out, and to heal the sick. But the love of money would cost him his eternity. You see, Judas lived on the edge, and when Satan had the opportunity, he pushed him and he fell. It is not hard to be pushed when you're on the edge. You're standing so close. Eve was willing to give an ear to the serpent. And this is very dangerous because the enemy has a way of mixing lies with truth and then making it sound reasonable. The enemy was able to deceive Eve, not just by what he said, but because Eve was willing to give an audience to the devil. But if you notice Jesus, when the enemy came to tempt him, Jesus spared no time, but using the word to speak against the enemy. Child of God, this is no time for us to give up. Do as Esther said, if I perish, I perish, but I must see the King. The thought of the day, whatever comes, Jesus, I'll go through with you. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.